Houtdubbelster, a car seat with leather. Made by me, Maya, stoffenstein.com. To begin with, take clear pictures of the seat. Front, left, right, under. Special close-up for the little springs. Take the back plate off with a hang tool. Turn the seat upside down. Your seat will come out now. To upholster a car, camper or van seat does not have to be difficult. However, an instruction for all type of seat is not possible. In this video I will try to be as complete as possible, so don't get nervous. You can use a staple lifter to take the clips out. A plastic or cardboard strip is sewn into the fabric and pushed into the frame. The little clips hold the fabric in place. Take clear pictures of the corners. That way you know how to fold them once your cover is ready. You're nearly ready to take your cover off. Yes, I said nearly. There are iron tubes in the foam. In the fabric you will find cotton piping, also with iron tubes. The tubes are fixed with hook rings. The next photos will show you how the hook rings work, so you know how to remove them. Get your pliers out and remove the hook rings. It's a bit hard work, but this should be your end result. So, time to move on to the back of your seat. The back of this particular seat is fastened with two plastic strips called male and female. This is how they work. 1, 2, 3, 4. To separate them from your seat, you will have to use a seam stripper. The inner side of the cover of the back is attached with Velcro. Other models might have hook rings or plastic strips. The cover is stuck to the headrest. Now it's important to remove the headrest first. The cardboard at the back is to keep the fabric of the cover firm. Remove the cardboard. The tubes of the headrest are shoved in another tube. They are held together with a clip. Remove the clips. Take the headrest out and you will be able to remove the cover. Mark the fabric pieces with an arrow for the warp, a U for underside, and write in your own words which piece is which. For example, top inner back, right side back, etc. Upon stitching the cover, this will be very important. Note, very, very important. It's time to start taking the old covers apart. We will begin with the seat. Mark the inside with seat. Just ignore my Dutch writing. Give a few marks, stripes, which parts of the fabric will be stitched together. Sometimes the old upholstery is out of shape, which makes it very difficult. Just look for the middle and mark it on the fabric. Later on we will make a half a mold. That way it will be symmetrical. Now cut your fabric in half and torn side and other parts loose. Make sure your marks are clearly visible. If you don't have much experience with sewing, sometimes it helps to work with numbers, so that number one will have to be stitched on number one. You get more and more loose pieces. Keep the pieces of the seat and back separate. The shapes are very similar altogether. In general, the pieces together should look a bit like this. If not, you're in trouble. The back should look like this. If not, you might be upholstering something else than a car seat. We are now making molds with upholstery cardboard. Stick the pieces of fabric onto the cardboard with an adhesive spray. If the form is symmetrical, put a line in the middle of your cardboard. Make an incision with a sanding knife. Fold it over and your mold is symmetrical. Some pieces of the old fabric don't look straight. But they are, so cut it in half and draw the first half on your cardboard. So you've drawn the first half, now draw a line in the middle, make an incision with your knife and fold it over. Draw the other half, now you have a symmetrical mold, and cut it out. mark the cardboard with seat, back seat, middle piece, whatever you think is the best way for you. An arrow for the warp. Again, ignore my Dutch writing, but this is how your mold should look like. This is how the mold looks for your seat. I use special pliers, but a pencil or a pair of scissors will do as well. This is how the mold looks for your back. If you like to upholster your chair with a fabric, be aware that fabrics are 1.40 meters wide. Think about the warp. You mark the warp with an arrow and your molds and you, meaning underside. Here's a picture how the warp should go. If you want to upholster your car seat with artificial leather, some call it Sky, which is a brand name, artificial leather is also 1.40 meters wide. The warp is not important, but keep in mind that it stretches. Cut the larger pieces straight from top to end and do not cut it diagonal. In this example, I upholstered the seat with leather. For two seats, I've used one skin of 5.5 square meters. The skins are sold per square meter. You can buy half or a whole skin. It's a natural product, so be aware of scars, neck creases, etc. You cannot use all parts of the skin. Puzzle your molds onto the skin. There's a special chalk pen to draw onto leather. But first, check the skin for insect bites and other scars and do not use that part of the skin. Do that as well as the top side and the back side. For in the car, you use half cotton, half polyester thread. This to damp, warmth and cold. Now, hey, finally you can start with stitching. Make sure you have enough bobbins with the same thread as your top bobbin. Begin with the middle parts of the seat, the front and the back piece. Make sure your markings meet each other. You could also stitch the cotton tubes in this seam. If you do it afterwards, pay attention to your thread of the seam. Do not stitch the tubes if the complete cover is finished. It's difficult to reach on your machine. Stitch at 1 centimeter of the edge. After you've done the middle pieces, start stitching the side pieces to each other. Make sure your markings meet each other. And now, stitch both side pieces onto the middle piece. Fit the cover onto the seat. It will not look perfect because the fabric is not fastened to the iron tubes yet, so don't panic. The last thing to do is to stitch the plastic strip on the edge of the fabric. Fit the cover again and see if the plastic strip will fit in the frame. Shove the iron tubes in the cotton tubes and fasten it with hook ring pliers. I've already explained how they work, didn't I not? Now turn the seat around and push the plastic strip in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And there you are. Let's move on to the back. The principles are the same. First stitch the middle pieces together. Stitch one side piece on the middle pieces and fit the cover. This is important. Now stitch the other side piece on the middle pieces and fit again. Stitch the side sleeves to the inner side of the back. Pay attention to your markings. I can't say it often enough. Fit the cover. It will not look perfect, as you still have to stitch the backside into the cover. You can push your Velcro into the back to see if it will fit. If you want a lock stitch, the best time to do so is now. Stitch the backside onto the front side of the cover. And yes, again your markings. Your cover is nearly ready. fit it again. It's really exciting, but this time this is a bit more difficult. Just follow the next few steps. Shove the cover over the back this way, inside out. It gives you the space to put the seam right, and you are in control over the Velcro. The cover will not fit perfect, because you still need to stitch the plastic strip at the bottom. So, if you're happy the way your cover fits, stitch the plastic strip. If your cover is on again, wait a moment before closing clicking the plastic strip. Shove the cover a little bit up. Now puncture two small holes in the leather at the top for the headrest tubes. Fasten the clips and put the cardboard back in. Pull the cover tight and straight, click and close the plastic strip. Please note, there's no way back now. Screw the back plate at the backside back. Your car seat is ready. Congratulations! Good luck with your DIY upholstery of your car seat. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If your foam needs to be replaced, just contact your local upholstery shop. Hope to see you soon on StoffenStain.com.